Welcome back, everyone, to our Let's Play series of Motorsport Manager. So here we are roughly halfway through the season. If we take a look at the standings here on the right side of the screen, we are, first of all, we have some American domination going on in the standings as the two of us are within 8 points of each other, but then we nearly double the third place team. So a very nice showing for the Americans at this particular point in time. But it also goes to show, if we focus on between us and Hammer, it goes to show the difference in how the teams are constructed. So we'll take a look at the standings tab to get a little bit better look at this. And if we take a look at driver standings, you can see that Eskin, who is a great driver, 4 wins, 45 points, again, nearly double the next place competitor. But the difference in how the teams are constructed is, if we look to find the other Hammer driver down in the list, we have to go all the way down to 14th and a mere 3 points on the season. So this team is constructed with find an absolute premium driver, the best driver that you could possibly get. In this case, they've done a great job pairing up a great driver with a great car. And then the other driver is just sort of there. You're either developing a new driver or you're getting the best driver that you can afford after paying a huge amount to your number one driver. The same thing in general is happening with Spartan. We see right here, we've got 18 points for their number one driver, but then we have to go all the way down and we see no points for their second driver. So our team is not constructed that way. I tried to find two of the best drivers I could get, signed both of them, and we're sort of sharing points here to try to get to the same place as Hammer and the other teams. So with that in mind, let's go ahead and move along. Again, we're roughly halfway through the season, a little bit past that, and we're in great shape right now, a lot better shape than I thought we would be in. So from that perspective, I'm really excited for this being our final season that I have planned in Motorsport Manager, and to even have a chance at the title is pretty awesome. All right, so we're going through our normal emails here that we get a little bit of morale boost. And finally, we've got an interview. Let's see what they want from us here. Let's see, was beaten by Eskin. Yes, most everybody has been all year long. Would you consider bringing him in next season? And we'll go ahead and say that. Now, that I would have imagined would have hurt morale for our two existing drivers a little bit. But one thing I knew it was going to do is giving us the buttered up trait for Eskin, which enables us to discuss terms with him. Now, again, with this being the last planned season, I'm not really going to be messing with that, but it is always nice to know that you have a shot at bringing in the best driver in this particular circuit if you should decide to do that. All right, let's see what we've got for new emails. Again, rumors and things, not really concerned with that. Okay, becoming a minister. So we've got a tremendous distraction here. So we've got minus one on everything. Again, this is not what we need right now. This is where we need to be focused. And of course, this distraction makes it even worse. I'm not concerned with the morale. I don't want you feeling good. I want you performing good. So these things outside of racing are nothing but distractions. And this is not going to help us in any way. So we've got an upcoming vote, and as usual, we get a potential bribe here. And in this case, let's see, voting in favor of both. No, no, thank you. We're not going to take that because, again, I'm not really all that worried about the money at this point. Move forward a little bit more so that we can get the car repair finished. So that means we can now come in, take a look at the car. And so since it's been a little while since I've been able to play the game and do any recording, I'm just going to take a quick look and see what we've got. I know we're working on an engine. That's our new part that's being worked on right now. It looks like it's 15 days out, which we'll finish just before our next Grand Prix. So we've got 83% reliability there. We're doing great on brakes. 82 and 78, we're more or less okay there. Gearboxes, you can see we are working fast and furiously to get this one up. Already at 99% with our other one. So great things happening there, 79 and then 89 with our suspension, which these two components we've not even touched as far as new development in this particular season. And in all likelihood, we probably will not either. So overall, we're trying to get this gearbox up to standards. And with that in mind, let's go ahead and let's see, what do we want to work on? Let's go ahead and work on brakes a little bit. Now, I don't want to put any emphasis on it. I just sort of want them to get a few points here and there as we can, while our real focus is going to be on reliability of this new gearbox. Okay, we've got three sponsorship offers in our sponsor slot. Let's take a look and see what we're looking for. Okay, so we got third, fourth, and sixth. Let's see what we've got in these other slots. We got a 13th or above and a victory option. So here we need to really focus and see what we've got. All right, so we've got a very short term, not much money up front here though. And then eight races with a nice upfront payment, and then six races with a nice upfront payment. The question is, do we think we can get third or above or fourth or above? And I think we can. I'm actually going to go pretty aggressive here, and let's go with the third or above. Get that nice upfront money plus a nice bonus if we can get there. Now, of course, I don't think we're going to be able to get there, particularly in qualifying, but that's okay because we're doing great on money right now. We're going to continue to develop new parts and pieces as fast as, and furiously as we can. Okay, you can see reliability work is almost done. Let's go ahead and move that forward a few more days. Okay, there we go. Now it's telling us that the reliability work is complete. And the next message we would have gotten would have been letting us know that, hey, there's nothing else being worked on. So here we are. We've got two parts in here. And the reason I'm only using two, I could put four in here. But since we really don't have anything that we need to work on, I'm actually going to put this engine over there. But I'm going to keep performance as the focus here. We're going to focus on, let's see, do we have a whole lot here for gearbox or engine? I know we're working on, this is going to be done 3 days before the race, but I'm pretty excited at this point about improving this engine. So 657, 678. Now I'm not going to improve the other engine, mainly because I know we've got a new engine that will be coming and we'll be spending our time working on it whenever it's done here in about, I believe about 9 days. So I don't want to really spend a lot of time working on that, but I do want to work on some of these other parts, particularly these, since these are two epic parts. Probably not going to get an opportunity to do anything with those for the remainder of the year as far as new development. So we're going to stay with this. And so far, so good. We're going to get these three parts as best we can. Looks like they'll be completely done one day after the race, which means that by race time, we should be in great shape with these and hopefully a little bit more reliability on this engine. And it's what we hope to be its final race. Okay, there's our new engine that is about to be completed. Okay, now we're up to 82 there. We're doing great on these other parts. So very close to maxing these out. Let's see what kind of emails we've got. Let's see, an update on our championship target. Reminder that we're currently in second place and our target was fourth. So yes, we're in great shape there. Our job is definitely not in jeopardy. And our staff is requesting that we spend some more money by upgrading more buildings, which of course we're not interested in doing right now. That would be a great idea if we planned on running more seasons, but since we are not, we're not going to focus on that. So we've got our engine that is now finished, which is in great shape. Okay, let's take a look at how that works itself out. First and foremost, we're going to add this in and work on reliability. And of course, it's not going to be ready for this race, which is perfectly fine, as much as I would like for it to be. That is perfectly fine that it is not. We're going to add it in for improvements. And you can see this is going to be a big, big improvement. Again, not this race, but next race. Because we got one car that's going to be going from 627 to 671, and then the other going from 671 to 687. So not as huge of a jump there as it is for our second driver. Okay, so everything looks good here. We're going to now focus everything on reliability, and we're going to move things forward a couple of days. I almost forgot. Let's see what we can get going with designing. So we lost a couple of days there, mostly because I forgot. So let's take a look. What do we get? Well, for one thing, we've already got, wow, went from 40 to 57%. Very nice in just a couple of days. That's what I like to see. So an engine, if we're going to make another engine, we need to get above 700, probably above like 715 or so. Let's see what we can do on that and see if that's even possible. Now we can produce an additional part, okay, which is not bad at all. We've got four open slots. So let's see what we can do with these. So top speed plus 40, but that's on the max. Let's go ahead and start by, let's see, minus 3 days, which is good. And there, now that leaves us one more slot. Okay, so that is 687 to 698, which is not exactly what we're looking for. And I don't want to choose this one because that would give me the risk level. Okay, so we can get up to 738 doing this. Now, it lowers our reliability some. That's not a huge issue. I think 738, let's go ahead. Let's back out of that for the time being. Okay, and the reason is I want to take a look at some other things. What about the brakes? Let's see, 536. Let's see what we can do on some new brakes. We've got three slots opened up here. And let's do here, here, and here. So 546. There, do we want to mess with that? 546 on brakes. It would give us a jump of about 40 here. So that's not bad. We know that gearbox isn't going to get us really all that much because we're already in the epic category there. Spoilers, 372. Let's see what we can do on spoiler. Okay, that's nice. Let's go ahead. And this should also be fairly quick. So you can see roughly 6 days on that. And then the very next level is, well, appears to be useless for us. Okay, but at least we're going to get some improvement, and it won't take all that long to achieve it. So let's go that direction. Make sure everything's where we want it. Reliability is the focus. There, we're working on some other parts as well. So we're reaching a point in the season where continuing to work on new parts is getting, we're reaching diminishing returns for sure. All right, so we're going to choose third and above, and that's going to be very difficult for us to do, particularly in qualifying. So, but we still gain 600,000 if we can get at least one of our cars to third or higher in the race. So I'm pretty excited about that. Getting wins is not all that hopeful for us at this point. Okay, so we're not quite ready to move up to this new engine, which means that our parts are all set. Okay, so we're in good shape here. All the parts and pieces are where we need them. Let's move back over. Parts are ready. Sponsors are ready. So let's head to the racetrack. So practice and qualifying now out of the way. We're ready for the race. And we've had a nice little turn of events here for us, and that it is raining. And the reason I say that's a nice turn of events is because normally whenever you qualify in the top 10, which we did with Fetterman, qualified 5th and 11th, normally when you qualify in the top 10, you are locked and have to start the race on your qualifying tires. But because it is now raining, The tires are unlocked, so that gives us a chance to start on a fresh set of tires. In this case, they will be Enters. And it looks like the rain is here to stay for at least the first, looks like 3 to 5 laps. So we're in good shape there. Let's take a look at our knowledge bonuses. We got a couple of tire bonuses here because we did not spend any time. The AI chose not to spend any time in race trim during practice. So we got a couple of pit stop bonuses for our second car with Reed. So our setups came away pretty good, considering I only made one adjustment right before qualifying to the setups. So not bad, 94%. Again, not quite 99 or 100% that you would like, but I'll take it for only one adjustment. We're gonna start on Enters. And 8 laps worth of fuel, which for us, because we pushed the engine, will turn into 7 laps. And here we see 8 to 10 laps there, and 8 laps of fuel, which of course will end up being 7. Our driver strategy, high engine mode for both, and we'll start out in neutral, even though the rest of the field will be on full attack mode. We may start to push things a little bit later on, but for now, we're going to start as we normally do. So again, we're going to be looking to make up as many points as we can, and the way we do that is to always try to make sure that we get both cars finishing in the points at the very least. All right, so everybody's on the full attack mode except for us, and here they go, trying to go by us on both sides. That is always nice. Unfortunately for us, whenever we push, we don't ever seem to get that much extra speed boost out of it. Okay, now here we go. Now I actually do want to begin pushing a little bit. As the other cars will start to calm that down a little bit on the tires, you can see they're starting to reduce that. Now we'll go back by at least a few of these cars and we'll start to see how the strategy is going to play out. What kind of speed do we have and what type of weather are we going to get? All right, looks like around lap 5 or so, we're going to get some nice weather for dry tires. So what I'm going to need to do is focus on really splitting up the cars here. It doesn't appear as though we have very much pace to get up there and run with them. But we are 7th and 11th, so that's not horrible. It's not where we need to be, of course. It's definitely not at our sponsorship objective of 3rd or above. But we're not in terrible shape right now. So the question is, when do I bring in my first car for the first pit stop? Getting on to the dry weather tires first could be a huge advantage or it could be a huge disadvantage. Okay, let's go ahead and bring in our first car. Yes, I like that idea. Let's go ahead and bring them in first. Fuel, of course, we're going to max that out. And pit strategy, we're going to hope for a quick pit stop there. All right, and I don't like to bring them in at the same time, but I don't think I'm going to have much of a choice here. Let's go ahead and do that. I don't like to stack them up, and hopefully it won't take very long, and they won't be terribly stacked up. All right, here we go. Let's move back up to our first car, and wow, yeah, they're going to be stacked up. Not what I wanted at all. 8.6 seconds. So we come out. We are the first cars to come out. We're going to go ahead and push a little bit here because the tires will last longer than the fuel does. I did not want to stack them up there, but you can see it. We are blowing by these guys right now. All right, so we come out in second position, and let's see, where do we come out with our second car? Looks like 14th. Okay, so that was my fault for stacking them up. We could have come out a lot better than that. But now we've got one car that is in great, great shape. Okay, let's back off with our second car. Not great strategy there by me, but I wanted to get both cars on, and I was hoping that getting on them at the same time, we'd have enough time in the pits to not stack up all that much, but we ended up having just a couple of seconds at the most. So it did not turn out well at all. Let's take another look at our... Ooh, so here we go. So we've got... All right, the tire degradation is really bad, but we're going to get another opportunity for some great, possibly great calls. I'll tell you what, let's go ahead and get a save in here. A nice break in the action. Hopefully it'll be a reminder for you, just as it is for me, to save early and often. Because I've had some issues, unfortunately, with crashing. Okay, so the track grip, we had just started to get up just a touch. Now it's going away because the rain is starting. Okay, so we're going to have, let's see, the rain is going to be starting very soon. Let's go ahead and pit with our second car. Go ahead and bring them into the pits again. Fill this thing full of fuel. That should mean our final stop is, I tell you what, we may back off and try to run this thing all the way to the end. That sounds like a pretty good idea to me. Let's go ahead and do that. I'm not sure if his tires will last that long, but we are going to try it. Okay, let's go ahead and put him down on low engine mode. Yes, he wants to come in for enters, and that's the idea that we had as well. So let's go ahead with that. So 9 laps. Actually, I'm not sure. Man, can we do that? I know we probably could if I run this thing all the way down to low engine mode, but I really, really don't want to do that with both cars. All right, we're trying to take the lead here as we come into the pits. Every second counts as you're getting into the pits. So here we go. All right, they're staying out. We're coming in. We're going to pick up the enters. And let's just go ahead and push. Now the enters should give us quite a bit more grip. We are the only ones in the top 6, really in the top 10, I think, that are on enters. All right, and they're staying out once again. So this should give us a tremendous advantage. All right, so remember, our second car is on the strategy of trying to finish out this race on a single set of tires. So we're gonna see how that works out. I'm gonna have to back off the tires a little bit. Oh, what happened there? We should have blown by them quite easily. All right, here we go. So now we move up to second. And why my guy is not attempting to get past. There we go. So we finally make the pass. We're in first with a nice little lead. Let's see what our weather's going to look like. Okay, looks like it's not going to come back down on the wetness to mean soft tires for us. So let's go ahead and just keep pushing this thing and try to get as big a lead as we can. You can see here in the top right-hand corner, the lead we have over second and third, which is going great right now. All right, we're in ninth, now 10th, wow, 11th, and back up to 10th with our second place car. All right, we know we're going to have to come in one more time. We know we're going to have to do that. But that's okay, because it should be just be for a quick splash and perhaps a change of tire. Maybe. We'll see how that goes. All right, let's see where we are on lap times. We are running, okay, we're even with the second, the third place car, and faster than the second place car. So we've got a nice situation there. All right, so as we come back around, we are going to make this last as best we can. So we got 3 laps left, and I'm going to have to make another stop for fuel. It's just nowhere around it that I am aware of. All right, let's move our engine mode up here because I think we're going to be in good shape to make it. We are in seventh, and we've got to move up a little bit more. Okay, there we go. So now we have two laps remaining. I am going to come in for a very quick splash of fuel. There we go. Pit stop. I don't see any reason to push that and risk anything. So let's just go with a 3-second pit stop. I'll tell you what, the tires, if I change tires, oh, that takes us to 7. Okay. And we got still got 33% left on the tires. The inters really don't have a cliff on them. All right, I think we're in good shape. I'm going to be watching here for the number 2 place car. Do we have enough of a lead? And it looks like we will have plenty of a lead. Final laps, we came in, got that little splash. All right, let's go ahead and push to try to get out of 8th. So we're in the lead, and we also have 8th position. And, okay, we're not going to be able to really get anywhere out of 8th. So that is not what we were looking for, but we do get the win. Okay, so very nicely done there. Fetterman comes home with the win. 8th place is not what we were hoping for, but that's on me because of the pit strategy. And getting these guys stacked up in the pits did not work as I was hoping. But hey, those are the breaks, and I am very, very happy with the win. A very good result for us. And while I'm thinking about it, let's go ahead and save again, because there is nothing worse than having a great finish nullified by a game crash. So scrutineering is not an issue for us since we don't have any parts that could even possibly fail. All right, so Hammer, the question is, where did Hammer come in? Oh, they came in above us. So they're going to get, we're still going to gain on them a little bit, but not quite as many points as I was hoping to gain, since they're going to come home with a total of 7.6 here from the podium, plus an additional 1 from, I believe, Eskin down in 5th place. We do not get any points with our number 2 driver, but we do get the win, which is 10 points. So very nicely done. It puts us at 2nd and 3rd in the driver championship, and we're now only 5 positions out in the team standings. So I will definitely take that. All right, let's move on to our final few screens. And it always worries me when the little circle doesn't move quite as fast. It makes me think there's a little hitch there and we might get a crash. Because unfortunately, I've become gun shy because I've seen that too many times in this game. All right, so everything is wonderful. Morale 100% across the board, including the chairman happiness and team marketability, only increases a mere 1% to 81% with the victory. Of course, we came in first as a team and we were expected 4, so we are in great shape. We lose a little over $1 million, almost 1.1. That is okay with me. So we get our final save in. All right, and as we come back to the home screen, I thank you very much for joining me in a great race where we were able to pull off the victory. And stay tuned for more Motorsport Manager.